Now, the next is for us to move on to what we mean by functional group. Because the first thing you need to do when you are naming an organic compound is to identify the functional group in the compound. And the functional group of the compound is peculiar to a particular family of organic compounds. A functional group is an atom or group of atoms that is common to all members of a particular homologous series and as well determine their chemical properties. Now, I'm going to prepare a table and we shall do that together. On the table, I'll give you some common functional groups, the name of the family, the prefix name, the suffix name, the general formula, as well as the general molecular formula. So here, we have about six columns. Family, functional group, general formula. We have the general, molecular formula. We have the prefix name, and we have the suffix name. So let's go. Now, on this table, I'm going to prepare the table by numbering the family or the functional group in their order of priorities. We are going to talk more about that by the time we start looking at examples on the how to name some compounds. So the first and the least prioritized functional group is the haloalkanes. Haloalkanes, the one you also refer to as alkyl halide. That's the name of the family of homologous series. The functional group is X, where X represents an halogen. An halogen can be fluoro, chloro, bromo, or iodine. The general formula is CN H2N plus 1X, while the general molecular formula is RX. The prefix name is halo, and their suffix name is alkane. So that means alkyl halides are derivatives of alkanes. Then we have alkoxy alkanes. Those are what we refer to as ethers. Ethers. Now the functional group is OR. Of course, this is also an alkyl group. OR. So the general formula is CN H2N plus 1 O. Although this I used to because we have two types of ethers. They are symmetric. They are symmetric ethers and they are asymmetric ethers. So I'm using this for symmetric ethers. For asymmetric ethers, this might not follow the same pattern. So the general formula is ROR. Alkoxy is the prefix name and the suffix is alkane. Now, next we have the alkanes. We also refer to them as paraffins. That's the old name. No functional group, but the general formula is CnH2n plus 2. Why the general molecular formula is this? The prefix name is yl, that is alkyl. Alkyl, yl, and the suffix is A. Alkane. Next, we have the alkynes, where the functional group is carbon-carbon triple bonds. The general formula is RC triple bond CR. The general molecular formula is The general formula is CnH2n minus 2. Why this is RC triple bond CR? We have the enyl, and that is I as the suffix name. Then next we have the alkynes, that is C double bond, C double bond. You have CnH2n, that is R2, C double bond, CR2. These alkyl groups might not be the same. We have the, the alkyne is inyl. It must be Y. Why the alkene is enyl, and that is in. Are you not surprised that alkynes come before alkenes? Meaning, alkenes have higher priority over alkynes. I've explained that in the hybridization because of the differences in electronegativity. Alkenes are less electronegative than alkynes, so the pi bond electrons in alkene are not as closer to the nucleus of the carbon atom. Of the molecule compared to alkyne due to differences in percentage S character. Then next we have akana means. The one we refer to as a means. The functional group is dash NH2. Then we have CN A2N plus 1 NH2. That is R NH2. And we have amino as the name of substituent, amine as the name of the family. Then next we have the thiols. The thiols. The functional group is SH. Their general formula is CnA2n plus 1 SH. The general molecular formula is RSH. We name them as substituent macapto and here as thiol. That is methane thiol. That's CH3C. Now, I will have to rub off some of this, especially leaving the last written functional group of families, so that we can proceed from where we stopped. Now, after the thiols, the next functional groups of family are the alkanols or phenols. We have the alkanols. You also refer to them as alcohols or phenols. These are organic compounds containing hydroxy functional group, OH. The general formula is CnH2n plus 1OH. That only goes for alkanols. But for phenols, we represent it as CCH5OH in most cases. So this is ROH, prefix hydroxy, suffix of. Then we have the alkanones, which have higher priority than alkanols. That is the first carbonyl functional group containing compound. Any compound that has this carbon oxygen double bond, we refer to it to them as carbonyl compound. So that means this functional group is a carbonyl functional group. So we have CnH2n plus 1. This is not necessary. Plus 1, COR. So the general formula is RCOR. We have the oxo as the name, and the suffix name is O. Then we have the alkanes, or the aldehydes. The alkanones are called the ketones. Those are also carbonyl group containing organic compound, OH, instead of alkyl group. You have CnA2n plus 1, CHO. That is RCHO. We name them as oxo as well, usually, or oxamide. Then the suffix name is R. Then after alkanes, we have the alkanamides. Alkanamides, the functional group is CONH2. That is CnH2n plus 1 NCO. CONH2, RCONH2. This is not specific. Amide is the suffix name. The next, we have the alkanoid halides. Alkanoid halides. I think I've omitted one functional group. We are coming back to that. Alkanoid halides. You also call them acyl halides. So they have the functional group of COX, where X is an halogen. That's CnH2n plus 1, COX, and that is RCOX. Then here we have oil halide. What I missed was alkylonitrile. And these alkylonitriles are actually supposed to come before alkanones. So they are the next after alkanones. So we have C triple bond N, that's CnH2n plus 1 CN, that is R C triple bond N. This is cyano, and this is nitrile. Then Remaining three functional groups, we have the alkanoates, the one you refer to as esters, that is COOR, that's the functional group, CnH2n plus 1, CO2R, you have R, COOR, no soft prefix name, but the suffix name is OH. And the last two, permit me to clean this, the last two are the last three, we still have three more. We have the acid anhydride, the alkaloid acid, and the sulfonic acid. The alkaloid anhydride, alkaloid anhydride. Here we have the CO-OCO-, that's the functional group, these are alkyl groups. We have the general formula CnH2n plus 1 CO2O. The general molecular formula RCO2COR. Is that correct? Yes, there should be three oxygen atoms, that is correct. Then we have the prefix name, nil, the suffix name, oic and hydride. Oic and hydride. Then we have the alkanoic acid, the most commonly encountered functional group of the highest priority, alkanoic acid. We have the COOH, that's CnH2n plus 1, CO2H, that is RCOOH. The prefix name, nil, the suffix name, oic acid. Then lastly, we have the sulfonic acid. Sulfonic acid. That is commonly like this, SO3H. CnH2n plus 1, SO3H. And then we have RSO3H. No prefix name, suffix name, sulfonic acid. So these are commonly encountered functional groups. You must know all these functional groups offhand and the order of their priorities. Because you may have a compound having two or three functional groups. How will you know which one will bear the root name of the compound? Now let's go to naming organic compounds proper. By taking examples on some of the compounds to be named. Here, you have to bear in mind the rules that were earlier stated, starting from identifying the functional group in the compound, identifying the longest carbon chain length and the number of carbon atoms in the compound, and ability to be able to number the carbon atoms from the carbon that bears the functional group that will give the least position of the functional group of the compound. Take for instance, we start from alkene. Look at this. This is the condensed formula CH3 3 CC, CH3 2 C, okay, CH, CH2, CH3, CH2, C, CH3 3. If you are given this kind of compound to name, it is better for you to write the structural formula or the skeletal formula. I'm going to write the two. The structural formula is, on this carbon, there are three methyl groups attached to it. So this is the carbon, the first methyl group, the second methyl group, the third methyl group. Then that carbon is linked to another carbon. On that carbon, there are also two methyl groups linked to another carbon containing one hydrogen and ethyl group. Linked to another carbon containing two hydrogen atoms. Linked to another carbon containing three methyl groups. Now the stick formula of this compound is this. Look at this carbon. This is the carbon here, linked to another carbon. That carbon is linked to another carbon. On this carbon, there are two methyl groups. So this is a methyl group, this is another methyl group. So this is this carbon, linked to this carbon. But on this carbon, there are two methyl groups as well. Sorry, it has to cut the angle on this. So this is this carbon, linked to this carbon. But on this carbon, there is a methyl group. There is a methyl group, which is this. Then there is this a methylene group linked to another carbon containing three methyl groups. This is the fourth methyl group, the second methyl group, the third methyl group. That's the stick formula or the skeletal formula. Now, the next thing is, since there is no functional group in this compound, you have to identify the longest carbon chain length. Starting from here, anytime. If you start from here, this is a carbon chain length. 1, 2, 3, it ended here. This also ends here, three carbon atoms. But you can go this direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is greater than 3. You can as well go this way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 is greater than 4, that has nullified the first two. Then you can go straight down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Or 6, 7. Meaning we have 7 carbon atoms on the straight chain. Now when you have alkanes without functional group, it is better for you to number the carbon atoms from either end, so as for you to know which one will give the least position of the functional group. So with 7 carbon atoms, it means the root name of this compound is ethane. Now if we start our numbering from this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On carbon 2, there are 2 methyl groups. On carbon 4, there is an ethyl group. On carbon 5, there are 2 methyl groups. On carbon 6, there are 2 methyl groups. And in alphabetical order, ethyl comes before methyl. So we are going to name ethyl first. And before you name it, you must indicate the position of that substituent. And when you are writing a number and a letter, you separate number and letter from using hyphen or dash. Why two numbers by a comma? So the name of this compound, from the right-hand side, right-hand side naming, we have 4-ethyl, okay, 2-2-5-5-6-6, 2-2-5-5-6-6, hexamethyl, no other substituent, then we have ethyl. Now, if we start from the left-hand side, assuming our numbering begins from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then the ethyl group is still on carbon 4. Left hand side we have 4 ethyl. Then the methyl group, 2, 2, 3, 3, and 6, 6. 2, 2, 3, 3. Then we have 6, 6. Hexamethyl ethyl. Now, how will you know which one is correct out of these two? You are going to add all the numbers together. The direction that gives you the least total number of the substituent is the correct name. Here we have 4, 2, that's 6, 8, 13, 18, 24, 30. And here we have 4, 6, 8, 11, 14, 20, 26. 26 is less than 30. So this is correct while it is wrong, according to high impact system of naming. Now, I want us to look at another example, still on alkane. This time around, when you have a complex alkane, something of this nature, I'm using the stick formula because that is much more easier. Okay, and good. Then here, something like this here. And here, you have something like this. Then here, okay, you have something like that. How will you name this compound? Okay, let's assume here we have something like this, and here we have something like this. The first thing, since it's an alkane, you try to identify the longest carbon chain length. Okay, if we start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. But if you go this direction, 10, 11, 12. 12 is greater than 11. So that means you have to come this way. And so we have 12 from here to this side. Let's try from here to this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We still have 12. Meanwhile, this group and this group are the same. Both have the same number of carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here, if we number from the right hand side, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So on named alkyl groups, we have a methyl group here, another methyl group here, we have an ethyl group here, we have an isopropyl here, 1, 2, 3, isopropyl, because The alkyl group is attached to the main trade chain on the second carbon. Right here, what we have? We have, I think, isobutyl. Yes, let's look at that, isobutyl, because this is a CH2. This is a CH, this is a CH, CH3, CH3, then CH2. In the IUPAC system of naming, if you start from either from the left hand side, you are naming ethyl before you name the propyl and methyl. Methyl before propyl. So the ethyl is from the left hand side, we have 8-methyl. Okay, then the methyl group, we have one on carbon 11, we have another one on carbon 3 and carbon 6. We have 3, 6, 11. Trimethyl. Then here we have isopropyl here. See it on this carbon. You can number this carbon 1', then here 2'. So there is a methyl group here. Likewise here 1', 2', 3'. There is a methyl group here. So this is a propyl long chain. This is an ethyl long chain. So you name ethyl before propyl. On this carbon you have, so this is attached to carbon 7. This is 7. So on the first carbon of that ethyl, there is a methyl group. You have 1-methyl ethyl. Then you close the bracket. So on carbon 9, you also have a propyl. 9. So on the second carbon of the propyl, there is a methyl group. 2-methyl propyl. Close the bracket. Then the name of the compound, 12 carbon atoms, that is dodecane. 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 Okay? So now we want to look at how we can number from the right hand side. Let's look at that. We have from the right hand side, this will be carbon 1. Okay. Okay, this from the right hand side. Because we started our numbering from here. Let's start from the left hand side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, then 12. We still have dodecane. So again, we have ethyl, isopropyl, and this isobutyl substituent. So here, the ethyl group from this side is on carbon 5. So from left hand side, we have 5 ethyl. All this is for us to know which one will bear the correct name. Then here, the methyl group, one on carbon 2, another one on carbon 7, another one on carbon 10. So this is 2, 7, 10. Trimethyl. Then what again? We have this substituent, which is on carbon 7 this time around. 7. 1-methyl ethyl, you close the bracket, dash again. Then this substituent on carbon 4. 4, 2-methyl propyl, what? Do decay. Alright, let's identify which one is the correct name by having the total number 8, 11, 17, 28, 35, 36. 45, 47. 47 here is the total. 47. Here we have 5, 9, 16, 26, 33, 34, 38, 40. 40 is the total. So this is correct, while this is wrong, according to IUPAC system of naming.